this sort of thing. Just to talk, I suppose the title is Smart MES Systems for the Food and Beverage Industry. So let me crack on with this. As a company, Orbis provides smart manufacturing execution systems that enable our customers to optimize their processes and drive towards zero loss manufacturing. So we're very much focused on this idea of zero loss. And our markets then would be the global food and beverage industries. That'd be Ireland, UK, Europe, and the US. So I can talk a little bit more at the end about our customers. Is anybody still here? You have to stay. If we look at the food and beverage processors and just maybe focus a little bit on the challenges which they face, it's an increasingly competitive and complex set of challenges. So just looking at some of those, like if we look at, we say, the whole area of product consistency, typically you're processing raw materials with seasonal variation, so your raw material isn't a constant spec, I suppose, or a constant standard. So, you know, there's variations with the raw material coming in from the start. Secondly, you're also dealing with mixed mode processes. So typically, you're dealing with both batch continuous processes, and that introduces its own complexities. You know, process efficiency is key. So you're trying to keep an eye on your asset utilization and keeping your downtime, you know, eliminating downtime and bottlenecks and making sure that yields and losses are kept to a minimum. On the product quality side, you know, trying to make sure that you don't have variable quality or your quality within specifications. And typically, you're trying to build in this quality using in-process quality sampling. You also have the whole audit and compliance side of things. So you need traceability of your operation, and you need to be able to handle, you know, external audits and compliance from customers, from regulatory bodies, etc. Sustainability, environmental factors, utilities, emissions, and finally, global competition. Increasingly, you're in the global market and the global stage. So, if we look at, we'll say, a standard process, and this is a brewhouse actually. So what we have is automation, which is designed to deliver repeatable and consistent operation across each unit within a process train. So we have a process train. Okay, we have a process train. Transformation occurs at each stage. Stages are mapped using recipe-based control. Quality critical parameters are modulated against the recipe. Samples are analyzed. And in that scheme of things, you have repeatability and consistency, but it's not a fully optimized system in terms of control of the process. So losses can, and they do occur at every stage of the process, and this creates kind of a shadow factory effect where you almost have this inertia that's kind of pulling from the optimization or the best practice running of that plant and process. And these losses can be significant. Performance losses, quality losses, capacity, product, and utility losses. So this is, you know, there can be a significant amount of inherent loss within the system. MES systems then help to drive zero loss by optimizing efficiency, effectiveness, traceability, and sustainability. So on the efficiency side, what we're trying to do is run the units flat out quickly, you know, basically run them at rate lock, get rid of any bottlenecks, make sure that our availability is maximized and our yield is optimized. On the effectiveness side, we want to make sure that, you know, although we're running efficiently, we want to make sure that we're making the right product. So we're working within specifications. Our quality right first time is maximized. and our quality results are available online where we're taking manual samples, etc. You also need to be traceable. So batch records are available online with traceability of operation built in. Final piece, sustainability, is that, you know, we want to drive down zero losses. We want to control our emissions and effluent and our methane usage. MES, if you like, provides this kind of landscape which helps us address that loss problem. So what are the MES functions? At the bottom layer we have integration, then workflow, then information. If we look at these, integration really is the, you know, it's the horizontal integration across the process from raw materials in to finished product building. And it's the vertical integration from your control system and your manual entry of data through to the enterprise, the ERP system, the SAP. So two sides to that integration piece, horizontal and the vertical piece. The workflow is about a little bit more than just integrating data. It's also about orchestrating the workflows or the processes associated with scheduling, inventory, QC, and maintenance. So that's kind of making sure that you have proper integration of the processes and not just the data. That's the workflow piece. And finally, the data piece or the information piece. This is the real-time data collection, organizational storage of data. And if you look at this data piece, what we're looking at on the process side is typically parameters and events. On production, we're looking at recipes and programs. On the product side, we're looking at batches and transfers. On the equipment side, status and usage. On utilities, demand and usage. And on performance, KPIs and coordinates. So there's a multi-dimensional kind of data set there that we're seeking to map into this kind of data hub. So with this data hub in place, specific applications will operate in this data in the MES domain. And applications like visualization, paperless, track and trace, OEE, mass balance, and analytics. So the data hub here is probably the key component in terms of the MES solution. So what about smart manufacturing then, and where does that come into the scheme of things? So smart manufacturing is the convergence of a number of disciplines that are technologies that can be, I suppose, have a disruptive effect. So you've got this, industrial internet of things, you've got the cloud, you've got increased analytics, mobility, big data. So all of these, if you like, have a role to play or, you know, in this smart manufacturing kind of domain. So on the industrial internet of things, we're looking at inline analysis, more information. On the cloud, we're looking at centralized with SOAR, with the services-oriented architecture. On the analytics, we're looking at increased analytics and increased intelligence. On mobility, multiple form factors and remote access. Large volumes of operation data mix. The key point here is that we think that all of these, if you like, technologies converge on the MES, and that's actually where they come together and what the implications are for MES. So smart MES then is where you take your MES footprint, if you like, and you use these technologies to, I guess, transform traditional MES. So you've got cloud-enabled MES through a web API, support for mobility, and service-oriented architectures, convergence of technologies. You have a hope with an optimized data model, optimized performance, end-user configuration, etc. So what you're actually doing is you're mobilizing these technologies around your traditional MES domain to create what is effectively a new smart MES. And for the process industries, we think that that is the meaning of smart manufacturing for those industries. We think that it's very much around the MES piece. So what we envisage for our solutions then is that data hub, the application suite, the use of, if you like, the smart manufacturing technologies and vertical solutions then for the different industries that we operate. So for example, for dairy, for distilling, for brewing, these would typically be the space that we would tend to operate in. Industry templates provide, you know, reduced risk, reduced time for deployment, and standard solutions for the particular verticals of the industries. So that's it, really. That's just my few thoughts on smart MES and what it means for process industries, really, food and beverage. Any questions from anybody? Or is that? Who is it?